Good morning students, welcome back to Sheba Group of Schools online class. In the previous class we have studied De Moivre's theorem and we have solved some problems in this theorem. What is De Moivre's theorem? Cos theta plus I sin theta whole power n equal to cos n theta plus I sin n theta. That is, we have multiplied this power with the argument. Here theta is the argument. We can multiply this power with this argument. Suppose here minus means it is equal to also minus. Okay, and we use this De Moivre's theorem when our real part is cos theta and imaginary part is sin theta. Suppose our real part is sin and imaginary part is cos theta, means first we form this cos theta plus I sin theta. For that we can take I outside from these two. Taking I outside, we get cos theta minus I sin theta. Suppose nama form vandu sin theta plus I cos theta nu irundhadna, first take I outside, adukapra idai eppadi form pandrom, cos theta plus or minus I sin theta form ku maathana piragudhan we can use De Moivre's theorem. Understood? Now today let us continue the same exercise 2.8. our second sum is prove that equal to minus root 3. First consider the first bracket inside, that is, take this as z, root 3 by 2 plus I by 2. First we rewrite this as in polar form, that is equal to r into cos theta plus I sin theta, isn't it? Next to find r, r is modulus, that is square root of real part square. Here real part is root 3 by 2, squaring we get 3 by 4, plus imaginary part is 1 by 2, that is its square is 1 by 4. Here 4 is common, so taking as LCM, in the numerator we get 4 by 4. So 4 by 4 equal to 1, so root of 1 is also 1. So our r magnitude or modulus value is 1. Next we find the argument, that is alpha is equal to tan inverse of y by x modulus. This is equal to tan inverse of, here y is the coefficient of imaginary, that is 1 by 2, by real part, that is root 3 by 2. This is our coefficient of I part or imaginary part, and this is our real part. Cancelling, we get tan inverse of 1 by root 3. Okay, tan inverse of 1 by 3, 1 by root 3, this is 30 degree, isn't it? 30 degree means pi by 6. So our alpha is pi by 6. From this alpha, we find theta. Here, consider z, that is root 3 by 2 plus I by 2. This is lies in which quadrant? Plus plus, positive positive lies in first quadrant. So in first quadrant theta value is alpha, that is alpha equal to what? Pi by 6. So our theta value also pi by 6. Substituting z, therefore our z equal to our root 3 by 2 plus I by 2 equal to 1 into r value is 1. So 1 into cos of theta value is pi by 6. Cos pi by 6 plus I sin pi by 6. Okay, next consider its power is 5. Taking power is 5. Or raising the power to 5, on both sides we get cos pi by 6 plus I sin pi by 6 whole power 5. Using De Moivre's theorem here, so cos 5 pi by 6 plus I sin 5 pi by 6, since using De Moivre's theorem. De Moivre's theorem, we get this. This is root 3 by 2 plus I by 2 whole power 5. Similarly, we can write root 3 by 2 minus I by 2 the whole power 5 equal to, just change the sign of imaginary part only. Here plus, So it becomes minus I sine 5 pi by 6. Okay, this is our second bracket. Now adding these two, we get the left hand side, isn't it? Our left hand side is root 3 by 2 plus I by 2 power 5 plus root 3 by 2 minus I by 2 whole power 5. This is equal to, isn't plus whole power 5 is this and minus whole power 5 is this. Adding these two equations, we get cos 5 pi by 6 plus I sine 5 pi by 6 plus cos 5 pi by 6 minus I sine 5 pi by 6. Now cancelling these two, we get 2 times cos 5 pi by 6, isn't it? So this is equal to 2 times cos 5 pi by 6. 2 times cos 5 pi by 6. Right, cos pi by 6 as pi minus pi by 6. This is taking 6 as LCM, 6 minus 1 is 5. So we rewrite this as pi minus pi by 6. And 5 pi by 6 value is 5 into pi by 6 is 30, that is 150. Our 150 lies in second quadrant. In second quadrant, teacups. Second quadrant, sine is positive. Sine only positive, sine and its reciprocal is positive. So our cos value is negative. So minus 2 cos pi by 6. So equal to minus 2 into cos pi by 6 value is cos 30 is what? Root 3 by 2. Cancelling 2, we get minus root 3. This is our RHS. This is so LHS equal to RHS, hence proved. Understood. Next, listen, third one. Our third sum is this. Find the value of this one. First, consider sine pi by 10 plus I sine I cos pi by 10. And denote this by Z. That is, Z is equal to sine pi by 10 plus I cos pi by 10. Suppose 1 by z is what? 1 by z is reciprocal. So we change the sign of sign of imaginary part only. That is sine pi by 10 minus I cos pi by 10. Okay. Reciprocal means just change the sign of the imaginary part only. This is our 1 by z. This is our z. Substituting this value here. Therefore, 1 plus sin pi by 10 plus I cos pi by 10 by 1 plus sin pi by 10 minus I cos pi by 10 whole power 10 equal to 1 plus, this is our Z, okay, Z by 1 plus, this is our 1 by Z whole power 10. So 1 by Z, by taking this Z as LCM, we get Z plus 1 whole power 10. So this is equal to 1 plus Z into Z by 1 plus Z whole power 10. Okay, this is in the denominator. So write in reciprocal form, Z by 1 plus Z. These two gets cancelled, Z power 10. Okay. Instead, Z, we are substituting this sine pi by 10 plus I cos pi by 10. That is sine pi by 10 plus I cos pi by 10 whole power 10. Listen, our real part is sine. So, we can't use the De Moivre's theorem here. So, first, we rewrite this as, we know one formula is it what? Sine, sine theta plus I cos theta equal to, taking I outside, we get cos theta minus I sin theta, isn't it? Using this here. So I into cos, here theta is pi by 10. Cos pi by 10 minus I sin pi by 10 whole power 10. This 10 is common to I also. this is equal to I power 10, and here we using De Moivre's theorem now. So cos 10 pi by 10 minus I sin 10 pi by 10. So 10 10 gets cancelled, and I power 10 into cos pi minus I sin pi. Here we use De Moivre's theorem. De Moivre's theorem. Okay, cos pi minus I sin pi. This is equal to I power 10 is, we write this as I power 8, that means 4 multiples into I square, isn't it? And cos pi value is minus 1, minus I into sin pi value is 0. As simply, we should know cos pi plus I sin pi equal to, we write this as cis pi, isn't it? This is equal to minus 1. Direct ani podalam, cos pi plus I sin pi equal to minus 1. So this is 1, isn't it? I power 8 is 1, and I square is minus 1, and inside we get minus 1. So our answer is plus 1. So our value is plus 1. Understood? Listen, fourth sum. If 2 cos alpha equal to x plus 1 by x and 2 cos beta equal to y plus 1 by y, and show that 4 subdivisions are given. First, if from the given equations we find first x and find y from second one. Listen, 2 cos alpha equal to x plus 1 by x. Taking x as LCM, we get x square plus 1. Our left side is 2 cos alpha. Okay, cross multiplying we get 2x cos alpha equal to x square plus 1. Now bring this 2x cos alpha to right hand side, we get x square minus 2x cos alpha plus 1 equal to 0. Okay, now factorizing, we get x value. Here a is what? A is the coefficient of x square, and b is coefficient of x, that is minus 2 cos alpha, and c is our constant. So x is equal to, first write the formula, minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a equal to minus b, that is plus 2 cos alpha plus or minus square root of b square, that is 4 cos square alpha minus 4 into 1 into 1, that is 4 by 2 into 1. So you get 2 cos alpha plus or minus, now taking 4 outside. 4 outside and bring from root, we get 2. 2 into square root of cos square alpha minus 1 by 2. Now taking 2 outside from these two terms, in the numerator we get x is equal to 2 into cos alpha plus or minus root of, listen, this is cos square alpha minus 1. In these terms, we take minus 1 outside. That is minus 1 minus cos square alpha by 2. 2 2 gets cancelled. So cos alpha plus or minus square root of minus 1 minus cos square is sin square alpha. So cos alpha plus or minus root of, instead minus 1, we write I square, isn't it? Minus 1, we write I square. So I square sin square alpha. Now taking square root, we get I sin alpha. Okay, this is our x. Taking positive value only, cos alpha plus I sin alpha. Similarly, we can write y is equal to cos beta plus or minus I sin beta. From this equation we get the same only. Y is equal to cos beta plus or minus I sin beta. Now we get the values for x and y. Using these two, we have to prove the given 4 subdivisions. Okay. Our first subdivision is x by y plus y by x equal to 2 into cos of alpha minus beta. First consider x by y. what is x taking positive only? Cos alpha plus I sin alpha. By y is cos beta plus I sin beta. We write this as cos of quotient means we subtract the argument, isn't it? Alpha minus beta plus I sin of alpha minus beta. And y by x. Y by x is 1 by x by y. That means it's reciprocal. It's reciprocal means what? Just change the sign of the imaginary part only. That is cos of alpha minus beta minus I sin of alpha minus beta. Now adding these two. That is our left hand side. X by y plus y by x equal to. This is our x by y. So cos of alpha minus beta plus I sin of alpha minus beta plus cos of alpha minus beta minus I sin of alpha minus beta. Now these two gets cancelled. We get 2 times cos of alpha minus beta. This is our RHS, isn't it? Hence proved. Understood. Our fourth subdivision is x power m y power n plus 1 by x power m y power n equal to 2 cos of m alpha plus n beta. First consider this one. X power m y power n. Our x is cos alpha plus I sin alpha whole power m into y power n is cos beta plus I sin beta whole power n. Now using De Moivre's theorem, we multiplying this power with the argument. So cos m alpha plus I sin m alpha into cos n beta plus I sin n beta. Now this is in the product form. So product means we add the argument. That is m alpha plus n beta plus I sin of m alpha plus n beta. This is our x power m into y power n. Next, 1 by x power m y power n. That is its reciprocal. So change the sign of imaginary part only. That is cos of m alpha plus n beta minus I sin of m alpha plus n beta. Now adding these two we get. Our left hand side is x power m y power n plus 1 by x power m y power n is equal to, adding these two, cos of m alpha plus n beta plus I sin m alpha plus n beta plus cos of m alpha plus n beta minus I sin of m alpha plus n beta. So now cancelling these two terms, we get 2 times cos of m alpha plus n beta. This is our RHS. Hence proved. Understood. I hope you all understood today's class. Do the homework and revise all the example sums also. Thank you, students.